Current affairs is regarding the intergovernmental panel on climate change. Okay, so recently there was a working group 3, IPCC 3, for the sixth assessment that is about to come in 2022 in India. So it has been hosted by the MOEF, right? So apart from that, IPCC has come up with special reports. That is special report on climate change and the land. So this is the first time that they have come up with a report, and particularly on the land. Okay, so this you remember. And so in that particular report, they said that the global food system is contributing to one third of the all greenhouse gases, right? And there was also another special report on the ocean and cryosphere in changing climate. So what does it say? It's saying that there are increased temperatures, and there is further ocean acidification, marine heat waves, more frequency of El Nino and La Nina events. Okay, so these are the findings of this report. So here in ocean acidification, don't confuse that ocean acidification mean that the pH level is below 7, or you see that it doesn't mean it is in the category of the acid. So when generally when we say that if the pH level is less than 7, we say that is it acidic in nature. So when we say it's ocean acidification, doesn't mean it is in the acid nature, but it is coming towards the pH of less than 7. Okay, still it is in above 7 only, so remember that, right? So majority of students might be confusing here. And going little background about the IPCC, it is set up by the WMO and UNEP in 1988, right? So what does it do? It gives the regular assessments on the scientific basis of about the climate change. So this report is used by UNFCCC, and what steps we need to be taken. So this is like a input for the governments and various stakeholders, how we need to act for the climate action, right? So there is one practice MCQ. So see here, which among the following statements are true regarding the IPCC? It is a scientific panel, conducts its own research to publish assessment. Okay, and the second one says it is established by UNFCCC. See, the first statement said it is a scientific panel. Okay, so far it is fine. It conducts its own research. This is not true. So this statement is direct. I have taken the statement and changed directly from the IPCC website. So it clearly mentions there that it does not conduct any own research. What does it do? It takes the published reports, and from there it makes the assessment report, right? And gives to various stakeholders, right? To the governments or to the at an international forum, right? And second one says it is established by UNFCCC. No, we have just seen that it is by UNEP and World Meteorological Organization, right? So the option is none here. So the next kind of is regarding the World Energy Council. So this was set up in 1923. It is a UN accredited global energy body. So it has more than 3,000 members. It has like various stakeholders. It has countries, NGOs, right? So many state cooperation companies, academia, anything, right? So it gives the publications. So even this is also very much important, as we've seen that UPSC tends to ask about the reports, right? So it gives the World Energy Trilemma Index. What is trilemma stands for? Trilemma is nothing but dilemma is like confusion of choosing between the two, right? Trilemma is nothing but the confusion between selecting one from the three. So it compares the energy security, equity and environmental stability. According to these factors, it gives the rating country by country. So remember this. So it's headquarters in London, and its mission is to promote sustainable supply and use of energy for greater benefit of all people. Okay, so we have I have given one MCQ. So consider the following statements regarding the World Energy Council. So being a UN agency, it has member countries from UN. The member countries of UN are also part of UN. It is saying, this statement is saying that. Okay, the second statement is saying it helps energy transition and aims to promote the sustainable supply and use of energy for greater benefit of all people. Yeah, we have seen this. So this second statement is true. Now consider the first statement here. It is saying it is a UN agency. So you think this is true? No. See what I have said. What I have told is it is a UN accredited, right? So but it is not an UN agency like WHO or any other organization. It's not a UN agency. So again, on the nature of organization. Okay, so this is wrong. Only two is right. So the next current affairs is regarding the Kigali Amendment to the Montreal Protocol. So this came into force in 2019. Okay, so what is its objective? Its objective is to phase out the HFCs, which is a potent climate changing gas. Okay, it's like kind of greenhouse gas. So why? Because to avoid the up to 0.4 of the global temperature rise. So it is like we are in line with the objectives of the Paris Agreement and continuously protecting the ozone layer. Sorry. So what is India's contribution here? To reduce 87% by 2047 and base year is 2024-26. So now see, there is specific to India. What does that mean? But that mean that there is equal but differential responsibility, right? So a little bit background about this. So this amendment is to the Montreal Protocol. So Montreal Protocol has its origin in Vienna Convention in 1985. So it is the most successful protocol according to United Nations. And it has a universal ratification, mean all members of United Nations has ratified. This is an only convention that is ratified by all the member countries. And there is a multilateral fund to implement this protocol. So because of this multilateral protocol, there has been a proper assistance for the developing nations to implement this. So this point might be helping you in mains also. So if there is that kind of mechanism, that kind of right assistance for any convention or the protocol, say, so that will be like that they'll be giving you more results, like it is the most successful protocol, right? So one practice MCQ here, consider the following statements with respect to the Montreal Protocol. The first statement says Kigali Amendment is the first amendment to the Montreal Protocol. Kigali Amendment is legally binding with equal efforts from the member countries. It is saying the first amendment, this is the equal efforts. And the third statement says mainly aimed at further reducing the impact of impact on the ozone layer by HFCs. Now see one by one. It is saying the first amendment. This is not true because there are many amendments to the Montreal Protocol to include the other gases, right? So this is not. Generally, you see when these kind of statement is like too much factual is statement is given in options in UP MCQs. Generally, they turn not to be like true, right? But not universally applicable. But be conscious about these kind of options. Now the second statement is said is legally binding with equal efforts. We have just seen that India and other developing countries are following equal but differential responsibilities. So this statement is also true. Sorry, wrong. This statement is wrong. This statement is also wrong. And third one is Kigali Amendment is mainly focusing on reducing impact on ozone layer. So see here, this statement is not true because it is not mainly on the impact of ozone layer, but this is focusing on reducing the greenhouse impact of the HFCs. Okay, so this is also wrong. So that's the reason I use the word mainly. So none is the answer. So we have seen that we have seen the certain important focus areas of the international conventions, right? We also seen like how to think like a examiner, like see they voluntarily giving certain kind of options or they interchanging between the options. We have seen one tick them like how they interchange the options, right, in the statements, and we also did